Tesla is very adamant on their statement of not using LiDAR for their vehicles to accomplish full self-driving. Why is everyone else using LiDAR? Is LiDAR good? Is it bad? Let's discuss that in this video. Different companies are taking different approaches to full self-driving. No one has actually reached level 5 full self-driving yet, so really it's just anyone's game at this point. But right now, as it stands, Tesla seems to be the one in the lead. If you haven't seen any of the videos that owners are actually posting on YouTube, Twitter, or other social media platforms about the FSD beta, the rewrite that Elon said would be a quantum leap, then you are greatly missing out. Those videos that owners are posting show how well the car actually handles most of the situations. Now you can argue and say, well, Waymo already has their full self-driving system active in a city in Arizona. And to that, I would say, yes, it's working, but there are big issues with LiDAR. Now, what is LiDAR in the first place? LiDAR stands for light detection and ranging. Now, what does that basically mean? Well, there's a spinny thingy. I'm just gonna call it a spinny thingy because that's literally what it is. And in that spinny thingy, it shoots out lasers or light beams. And what it does is it waits for the light beam to return back and calculates how far that item is or object is from its location. And this can be very useful. This is basically what radar does, except using light waves, visible light spectrum. And this is not necessarily a bad thing. The iPhone 12 has it, and they're using it for a completely different purpose rather than full self-driving. And obviously they're using something that is much less precise, whereas the LiDAR used for cars is millimeter precision. It can measure something up to a certain distance with millimeter accuracy. The iPhone does not do that. I don't even know if it does centimeter precision, but that is highly possible. And I think reports have also came showing that the iPhone only does it up to about 16 feet. So not that far. That would be like a car driving about 3 to 4 miles an hour. And I've seen this argument made, well, why can't cars use LiDAR if the iPhone has it? Because of this reason. I'm pretty sure you don't want to be in a car that only goes 3 miles an hour because it can only see 16 feet in front of it. So why is Tesla not using LiDAR? So Tesla is very engineering based. They want to simplify things as much as possible, and everyone working there has a sort of engineering mindset, thinking from first principles. And there are some issues with LiDAR that present themselves before you even get started. Number one is cost. And here's what I think about cost. Cost can drop dramatically over time. Before, it costed about $70,000-$80,000 to just buy the equipment for LiDAR, let alone actually installing it on a vehicle. And that is very expensive. That's just the entire cost of the car itself. But now cost of LiDAR is dropping. I think it's about $25,000. And so cost is something we can get over if it proves to be a valuable asset. Now, the second reason why Tesla doesn't use LiDAR is because it's quite unreliable. I mean, think about this. You have physical cameras that don't move, don't do anything, like the ones you have in your phone pretty much. And what they're doing is they're just there, like they just work. You could take a 10-year-old phone and open up the camera, and obviously maybe the image quality is not that good, software processing, but as long as the phone works, the camera should also work, as long as everything works properly. And that's exactly the benefit using cameras. You have cameras that can detect everything, and obviously LiDAR isn't a replacement for cameras, it's just an add-on, but cameras can do the same thing that LiDAR can, and LiDAR is a spinny thing. It's literally something that is spinning outside of the vehicle, which means it's more prone to damage. So because of that reason, LiDAR is not really practical because, first of all, if it breaks, it's quite expensive to replace. Secondly, even if it does not break, it's just something that is waiting to be broken and that's quite useless and also ruins the design of the car. I mean, you look at any Tesla out today, especially any Model 3 or Model Y, which all have the sensor suite to make full self-driving viable on those vehicles. You look at those cars and they're pretty much like every other car on the road. Well, maybe they look nicer than every other car on the road. That's subjective, but they don't have some next external factor that distinguishes them from other vehicles on the road necessarily. For example, if you look at Waymo or Google self-driving cars, first of all, Google self-driving car, it looks like an orange. It looks like a ball with something on top of it. Like, it's weird. What? And then you take Waymo, for example. Waymo uses a Chrysler Pacifica, which is a pretty nice minivan, if I have to say myself, but You look at the sensor suite and you can tell that car is special. It has some self-driving equipment and whatnot. Whereas Tesla does not do any of that. It's all just built into the vehicle, and with LiDAR, you cannot get that. So it's just something to think about. Now, the third reason why Tesla doesn't use LiDAR is because it's redundant. There's no need to use LiDAR because LiDAR does not work in most of the situations where you want something to actually work and help the cameras. LiDAR does not work in fog. It does not work in snow. It does not work in rain. It does not work in hail. It basically doesn't work in most of the natural climates we have here on Earth. And because of that limitation for LiDAR, what you need is a beast of a vision system, and that's what Elon has been referring to. LiDAR is useless in that sense because during those times, LiDAR won't be used. And if you try to use it, it can't see anything. It's like driving blind, essentially, even in a light rainstorm. And so what you need with LiDAR is a really good vision system, which you need even though you're not using LiDAR. So really, LiDAR just becomes a secondary option for something that is less relevant and actually even less useful because it doesn't even work most of the times when you need some sort of help. Now, radar is different. Radar uses radio waves to determine the distance between the vehicle in front. And what radio waves do is they can see through rain, fog, hail, snow, just anything pretty clearly. If there's any rainfall, it can see other cars pretty clearly. And so that's why they use radar for adaptive cruise control, to keep you a safe distance away from the car in front. And radar is actually useful. It's not that expensive, it doesn't break easily, there's no real moving part, and it actually aids the cameras. It can actually detect distance with pretty good accuracy and see through most of the natural climate we have here on Earth. So radar makes total sense. LiDAR, not so much, even though it's trying to compensate for radar, if that makes any sense. So why is every other company using LiDAR? Well, for one, no one has actually reached full self-driving yet. So we don't really know what's the right method. It could be that Tesla's method is completely wrong and they just have to start from scratch and add LiDAR and whatever, you know, mission failed, full self-driving capabilities not coming to any of the cars that Elon promised it would. Tesla would probably refund their money at that point, but I see that as a highly unlikely scenario. I mean, think about it. Humans drive with two cameras, their eyes, and this is what Elon argues all the time. We have two cameras on a pretty bad gimbal system, our neck or head. And we drive pretty badly, but pretty well for how we should be driving. I mean, with two cameras only looking straight with a little bit of peripheral vision, we should be driving much worse than we are right now. So in that sense, you can say that cameras do a really good job. And now Tesla has the 360 degree cameras looking all around the car with a computer that reacts in milliseconds, not at the second time scale. Your brain reacts at the second time scale. If something happens, it takes a fraction of a second for your brain to compute and perform that task. Whereas for a computer, it takes milliseconds. It's 1,000 times quicker than you are. And here's gonna be my final point about LiDAR. What everyone else is doing other than Tesla and Comma AI is using LiDAR and mapping out the roads. So what you do with mapping is you have a vehicle or many vehicles that actually map out the road beforehand, measure exactly to millimeter accuracy where everything is, and then the car would drive, kind of like in a video game. But real life isn't a video game. Random things happen all the time. For example, if there is construction on a mapped road, the car is likely to have a much harder time to comprehend how to navigate that situation versus a car that relies on vision and that works like your brain. When you arrive at a situation when there's construction or pylons or really anything, you know how to navigate that situation. Maybe not well, because humans, you know, we create traffic jams, but we know how to navigate that situation. So we're not just completely stuck. We don't just turn off our cars. We're like, oh, we're done. That's it. We just have to wait for this construction to go. We're not like that. Tesla's system will be exactly the same. It'll work more like a human brain than a computer. And this can be seen by all those FSD beta videos the owners are putting out. It behaves a lot like a human. It waits, it navigates roads, it navigates around other cars, other objects, around people, much more like a human. And it drives much more like a human rather than what you would assume a computer would drive like. So when the Waymo vehicle approaches a construction zone in its path, It has to essentially rely on vision and just rely on everything that whoever coded the system taught it and what to do in that situation. Whereas Tesla's system, it works like that. It's literally intended for it. It doesn't even have to think about it. It's almost like it doesn't even care that there is construction. Its main purpose is to navigate the system, and the Tesla vehicle is just gonna go through it like it's nothing. Whereas Waymo might get stuck. And this is exactly why Waymo looks to be ahead when it actually isn't. Right now, it's only working in a city in Arizona on certain streets. Try taking that exact system, just take it outside of the city where their roads aren't mapped, and it would essentially fail. Not saying it would necessarily fail entirely, but it won't be able to do as good of a job or even close to as good of a job or remain as safe as it was in that playground, as I call it. What you have to do is take the car out of the playground. Once the car is out of the playground, you can determine if the car can navigate certain situations that humans can navigate without even thinking about. You have to design a full self-driving car like a human, and LiDAR just sort of restricts you like that. We don't have any sort of system that determines distance. We just have two eyeballs and we just know, okay, this is how far we are from the other car, this is how far we should remain. And we do a relatively good job. Sure, some people get killed on accidents, but based on what computers have taught us, there should be a lot more accidents. So we're a lot more safer than we were intended to be with driving. So in the end, it looks like Tesla is actually gonna be first to achieve complete full self-driving just because of what they're doing. And it also seems like LiDAR may not be the right approach. I think Elon was right the entire time that LiDAR is just not the right approach. But we have yet to see real full self-driving with no human supervision. And whenever that happens, times can change. Maybe Waymo will decide to drop LiDAR entirely. Tell me what your thoughts on this in the comments down below, and I'll talk to you there. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll talk to you later. Peace.